Well, Lisa Moore, it's been 97 days now since 1 4-month-old LaMelo Parker was gunned down in the middle of Biloxi at I-10, surrounded by law enforcement. Have a bit of information for you, unsubstantiated, unconfirmed by the Biloxi PD who is investigating this, but coming from very reliable sources. None, however, in this state, as my friends in Bethesda put it that way. We had some folks to view the video that showed the positioning of at least 5, maybe even 6 law enforcement officers just prior to the shooting. And well, I'll tell you what, let's just go ahead and play this. And so then, so you will give some perspective and brace yourself because you will hear the, I guess the last moments of one LaMelo Parker prior to his being shot. Of course, he did not die on the scene because we heard his screams right after the last shot was fired, but he was airlifted to Alabama. But listen at the shots very, very closely because there are some stragglers here that that we're going to visit or explain later. Here it is.
He's got a baby in the car, too. They need to get that baby out. Get him, dog. Get him, dog. Get him, dog. Get him, dog.
So toward the very end, when she was saying, holy, well, you know, it rhymes with spit, you were hearing the baby. Now, some of you, if you listen very closely or go to our Facebook page, you are actually able to hear LaMelo scream. Horrible situation, but there were 5 shots toward the end. And according to individuals who are very familiar with ballistics and even trajectory, the they indicated to me that more than likely, if in fact LaMelo's father, I use that term loosely, Smith, if in fact he did not kill his own son, then LaMelo died as a result of those last five shots. They had an opportunity to really evaluate this video. And just before the first shot happened, it looks like there was something black out of the window. Seemingly, the window was still up because you saw the glass shatter. Seemingly, the window was still up. And right after the first shot, whatever was outside of that window was pulled back. Again, this is not confirmed. This is just an evaluation by individuals who have seen a lot of this, let's put it that way. And according to them, it was at that point that Smith's body and head disappeared from view. From the front, because you have a frontal right side passenger view of this. And at that point, you can just barely see his head. And it's believed that at that point, Smith was mortally wounded and potentially leaning over his son. I gotta use that term loosely too. Let's just say LaMelo. And what the experts had to put in there was that it just depends on whether LaMelo was in the lap of Smith or to the right of Smith in the other bucket seat. But what they knew for sure and felt quite confident in saying to me was that based on the trajectory of law enforcement officers firing down into that car, the round that hit LaMelo could very well have passed through his father and into LaMelo. Interestingly enough, they noted that all the windows were up. And although it wasn't a very hot day, no doubt, probably was a little warm in the car. It suggested that maybe the air conditioning was still on. You could not hear the baby's voice before the shots, but you could hear them right after, which implies to the experts that there was a breakage of the window. They're pretty confident in saying that whoever fired the shot, if it was in fact law enforcement and not Smith from within the vehicle, then that shot came from the driver's side rear or from the driver's side window height. In other words, you realize where this vehicle was, ladies and gentlemen, was approximately 5 feet below the pavement, below the highway there. So in other words, you're about a man height aiming down at this vehicle. If you're aiming down at that vehicle into that window, then you're gonna, if in fact the round passes through that person, it's going to hit part of the seat on the passenger side. Or could very well go into whoever's in his lap. So I asked the question, so why do you think, why did they think this? And it was obvious. As they counted the officers who seemingly were around and were positioned to fire, there were five. Actually, there were six around, but not all of them fired. The man who had the gun, the officer, deputy who had the dog, did not fire. That seemingly was very well the deputy who got out of the vehicle that did the spin-out maneuver and then ran in between that vehicle and LaMelo's vehicle, which is a little odd to the experts, because if you were fearful of an assailant, then you would not run not only in between the vehicles, but also in front of the driver's side of the car. Maybe he got his bearings wrong. I don't know. But up until this point, there has been no attempt to shoot anyone else on the part of Smith, who had just went on a 250-mile beginning high-speed chase, later a creeping chase. He only going about 5 miles per hour when he ended up where he was. So it was the next place was a little bewildered as to why the deputy would take that move in that position. There's another trooper that pulls up in front, Caucasian trooper, that is within approximately 15 or 20 feet to the front bumper of Smith's vehicle, who had a bead. Now, according to my experts, that person more than likely would not have fired a shot that could very well have injured one LaMelo, because it was almost parallel. He had driven down into the swell of the road and was parallel, actually, to the ground and had a frontal shot of Smith. The expert counted at least 7 to 8 shots that hit the front windshield. He's suggesting that more than likely those shots were not the shots that resulted in the death of that baby. What he is saying, however, is that the shots that came, that ultimately ended Smith's life, came from the driver's side window and the rear on the driver's side. There was an African-American state trooper with a long gun who had a police car to the very rear. If you go to the video, you'll see this. And he exited his car from the driver's side and walked over to another state trooper vehicle. But he didn't fire his weapon. It didn't show him firing his weapon. We did not. Well, he could have when the camera panned away. We don't know. But he did have a long gun. But oddly enough, down toward the end, when the shooting was ending, there was another officer who seemingly came out of the woods. And we couldn't explain. We don't know whether he fired from the rear or not. Experts suggest that where this happened was there was a decision made to do it from this location, and there could have very well have been a sniper set up at that location. According to them, there's nothing done by accident. But he feels pretty certain that the round that killed this 4-month-old baby came from either the driver's side door or window after Smith was mortally wounded, very well passing through Smith, or Smith had LaMelo on his lap. And because of the trajectory, the round passed through the baby and into the seat. This is unconfirmed. This is all, this is merely an observation from people who know better than I. Upon looking at the video and evaluating it. One final thing. They said that more than likely, whatever this investigation will be inconclusive. More than likely. In other words, the round that probably ended up in LaMelo, more than likely, to very well not be found. And it may be several. The coroner indicated that he was shot. He did not say how many times, did he?
No.
It's horrible.
Actually, I take that back. The coroner, Brian Switzer, did say that the autopsy results revealed the cause of death was a single gunshot wound. However, we still don't have ballistics.
So the coroner said it was a single gunshot.
Single gunshot wound.
Yeah, okay. The mere fact that the expert suggested it will be inconclusive says what?
Says to me that
for some reason, the origin point of this bullet, this single gunshot, would be harder to find. Maybe because of the hail of gunfire. That's the only thing I could even begin to come up with as far as it being inclusive, it not being conclusive.
He did say this, though. He said that it is more than likely not conceivable that Smith shot the four-month-old point blank with whatever weapon. We know he didn't have a long gun. It was a handgun. I have no idea what kind it was. But he said even if it was a .22 at close range, the likelihood of that four-month-old surviving that shot at close range would have been slim to none. He would have died instantly. So they do not feel that Ranello was killed by Smith, his father, and I use that term loosely. All right, we will keep you posted. Have not been informed by the Biloxi PD that the investigation had been turned over to Parker, who is acting as the district attorney for Harrison County. By the way, there's a special election in November. And of course, for those who would qualify to run for district attorney, you have until September 3rd, I think, to qualify for that position. Not that you should, not that you shouldn't, but just as a point of information. Because we're not getting any information. We're not even getting an apology. We're not getting anything. And I think we, the public here, deserves better than this. That baby deserves better than this. There, I said it. Now I'll get very, very, even more serious with you, because I'm going to get very personal with you. You know, many of you know that I'm not vaccinated. I want you to really listen to what Rip Daniels is about to tell you now. With this variant, the Delta variant, going the way it's going, and with the behavior of all of us, nobody's going to get locked down again. The masks are off, and in many cases will stay off. Our behavior probably will not change. I want you to listen to me. It is not if, it is when you get COVID. You will more than likely get COVID. There is a 89% chance that you, my friend, will get COVID. There's a 98% chance that you'll survive it, you will live. 2% chance that you'll die. 2% of those who get COVID die. Sometimes it differs depending on where you are in access to medical care. 98%, as you have seen, have gotten COVID and survived it. But you need to tell yourself and ask yourself, what are you going to do when you get it? Because you will get it. Rip Daniels will get COVID. And I had prepared to get COVID. Figured I'd go through COVID, survived it, build some antibodies, do it the old way. Felt I was strong enough to not end up in the hospital. I still feel that way. I still feel that, you know, my immune system is very, very strong, and I don't have any really pre-existing conditions. May have some age disadvantages, but for the most part, you know, I feel like I'm in my 40s. But I know I'm going to get it. You need to know you're going to get it now. Now, here's what you got to ask yourself. Can you afford to be that sick? Well, you may not die. Can you afford to give up 14 days of your life sick as hell? I talked to my son, DeBar. He's sleeping now. Feeling better. But he's pushing up right now on what, 12 days? This black belt in karate, hell, there's a horse. young man can't go 15 minutes without taking a rest. He was my gauge. I'm getting the vaccine. I am getting the vaccine. Not because I think it's gonna kill me, but I don't wanna be that sick. And if there's one thing all the vaccines have proven, is that their track record for keeping people out of the hospital is far better than not having the vaccine. And I'll just say, I go into this very practical. Very practical. I don't want to get that sick. I don't like being sick at all. Actually, I very rarely get sick. It is not if, it is when I get COVID, even if I get the vaccine. But I know that with the vaccine, my chances of survival without being hospitalized is 98%. Now, of course, it's a little lesser, one would say. I've seen as low as 68, 67% with Pfizer or with Johnson & Johnson. That the Delta variant is a lot more virulent. Gotcha. But most of those individuals who are hospitalized are without a vaccine. Most of those who are dying from COVID-19 now are not those who have a vaccine. Commonsensical. So my decision to get the vaccine is born out of, well, you know, it's inconvenient for me to be sick. Besides the fact, I don't like being sick. And if I can take something that can keep me from being sick 14 days and thereby affect everyone else, I hadn't even gotten to that yet, but I mean the idea of getting that sick and then infecting a healthcare worker, first and foremost, people trying to help me, there's been 18,000 healthcare workers that died as a result of COVID-19 helping everybody else. That's horrible. You go in to save a life and your life is taken. I didn't even mention family members. As we speak now, we got what, 1, 2, 3 infected? Had 5 infected. By the way, the ladybugs are back in school. Mm-hmm. I didn't hear any applause. We're going to play their song too, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
Happy song. They're back in school, but trust me on this. Amelia's little bundles of joy were sick. One more than others. So Rip Daniels is going to get a vaccine. I want to get a vaccine today. You need to decide to do that now. I'm telling you to do that. I'm gonna tell you for one reason, one reason only. You don't want to be that sick. It's a prevention. It is a treatment. All the brouhaha about that, putting stuff in it and all that, trust me on this. Yeah, we have an incredible staff and we've done some serious studies on this. And what we have found, that the so-called vaccine, and I say that because it really isn't a vaccine. Vaccines prevent you from getting a disease. I mean, an inoculation means you're not going to get it. That's what inoculation is. And it's not there yet. I'm understanding that Pfizer's now is talking about approving the FDA is talking about approving Pfizer in the next week or so, according to Fauci. And I think that really is going to be a bastardized kind of approval, to be quite frank. I think it should meet the same track record. If it's a treatment, say it's a treatment. It's a treatment. It is a preventive treatment. It's not saying you can't get it. Of course, and now Fauci's suggesting that there's going to be worse variants. And I don't doubt that, because, ladies and gentlemen, viruses do what viruses do. They're unpredictable. It goes wherever it wants to go. You're not going to stop it unless you don't spread it. I had a test this morning. And I don't have COVID. So I'll get the vaccine. Gwen, I'm going to get the vaccine. And I say vaccine, I mean the emergency use treatment, drug prevention, whatever. For those of you who don't believe in it, it's okay. Just look at it as an aspirin. You know, you take an aspirin after you've had a few drinks, go to bed, you wake up without a headache. Now, it works on me. About the only medication I'm on is aspirin, to be quite frank. But I don't want to be as sick as Tabari. I mean, I'd be. I think I won't be. But I can't take that chance. Because I can't stop working. I got too much stuff to do. I don't need the inconvenience. Does that sound selfish? Yeah.
No.
It is selfish.
Let me explain why. It is on the surface level, right? But when you look really into what exactly it is that you do, a lot of other people depend on that. So it is and it isn't. Because your work, a lot of other people's work hinges on.
Oh, so you're looking out for your job. You're going to get a vaccine too?
I didn't say that. That's not what I said. I just said.
So why don't you get one?
What you just said wasn't necessary.
I can't afford for you to be sick.
You really can't.
I know.
I can't either.
So we need to go together. Think about it. It's just common sense.
I'm going to think about it.
It really is common sense. You are a million. It's not when. Folks, listen to me. It's not if. It is when. You get it. Remember, you're going to get it. I just did the numbers on this. The number of individuals who had the vaccines, and now you realize we are back to where we were, beyond where we were last year this time. Numbers don't lie. That, then you had, Lollapalooza there in Chicago, and another one of our ladybugs attended that, by the way, and she had came back with strep throat yesterday. Angelique, you got to go. I strep throat. Have you been tested? No. Bless her heart. Love you to death. Got to get up out of here. Our dear friend, social media guru, Andrea, got COVID. So it's not if, it's when, bro. Yeah, I mean, it really is. I mean, just do the math and you go, okay, well, now your next thing you have to control is how sick you're going to get. And there's no guarantees there. But the reality is that those who have the vaccine don't get nearly as sick. And the breakthroughs are very, very rare. It is not if you get COVID now. It's when you get COVID. With the number of Americans who have it, the percentages are right at 86% that you're going to bump into someone who have COVID. They may not know it because we don't test everywhere. If we were testing, I probably wouldn't get the vaccine. Really. If you and we were every 3 days having to test, as did I, every 3 days, every 4 days, even if it's once a week, and then determine who has it, okay, you've got it, I've got it, okay, well, then, you have to go. The viruses die out only when you can't spread it. That's the reason for vaccines. It says, okay, guess what? I have antibodies which will fight me from getting it. So I'll develop antibodies after getting my vaccine, right? And although I might get it, which I'm not supposed to actually, I mean, it's a contradiction of vaccines, then I will have something to fight. This quote-unquote vaccine has not been perfected yet because of all the variances. I mean, it's the same thing it's gonna be for the flu. When you go in and take a flu shot, they are anticipating a certain kind of strand of flu. You understand? So they'll give you a shot for that strand of flu, whether that it might mutate. But one thing's for sure, you're only going to go through 5 days, maybe. Between 3 to 5 days, you got the flu, feel miserable. 3 to 5 days. But with this, you can go through 14 days. There are people, my dear friend, Dr. Irons, are still going through it. Steve Delahousie. You chatted with an AMR director, former. He's got now a lung disease. I mean, you know, do you really want to take that chance? It is not if you get it, you're going to get it. See, I'm telling you, I'm giving it to you straight. I'm not giving it to you like the Faucis and the doctors. To say, oh, yeah, take the shot. It'll keep you from, no. I want you to take the shot because you don't need to be that sick. You want to grab those? You don't want to be that sick. I don't want to be that sick. You ain't losing no 14 days on my back, man. You kidding me? No. So I'm going to take the Johnson & Johnson. Someone just emailed me, why Johnson & Johnson? Because they did the vaccine the old way. That's why. And I'm not knocking Pfizer or Moderna or AstraZeneca or any of the others. However, my investigation of Johnson & Johnson is that they did it the old way. They did not use the RNA process using the ribonucleic acid to feed into a cell, and then the DNA produces some antibodies to combat a synthetic protein. I don't understand all that. I've read through it. I do understand it. What I don't understand is there's cause, there's effect. I don't know what the effect of messing with Mother Nature like that is. I'm sure it's going to be good. I hope so. Dear friends of mine who have taken it. But I just, you know, I'm not comfortable with the science. But however, when it comes to the Johnson & Johnson, there's mild. All of the after effects seemingly are more mild than the others. It's a one-shot situation. Not that Johnson & Johnson has a very great track record with pharmaceuticals. They've been sued a time or two and have settled some of those lawsuits. But the old way is that, okay, they went in and used the SARS, piece of SARS, and had that develop a protein like what you find on the COVID-19, and then, of course, you build antibodies that way. In other words, it's not synthetic. That's the key. I don't like that synthetic thing. No one's explained to me how you can do the synthetic. And then have it carried on acid. Acid is ribonucleic acid. You understand that's, you know, deoxyribonucleic acid is DNA. Ribonucleic acid is the messenger. It takes information, goes to the cell, and because it's acidic, it's able to penetrate the cell and all the way to the nucleus. And then the nucleus says, ooh, look what we got here, a protein. It's not supposed to be here. Antibodies, and then it goes in and it fights them. I had one question for a physician, and that was, okay, so since the ribonucleic acid carries this agent, he called it something else, I don't know. So it penetrates, goes in, and what happens to the acid? I mean, how does the body deal with the fact that the acid carried this synthetic protein? He couldn't answer that. I don't know what his answer is. I mean, it just disappears. It dissipates. I mean, the ribonucleic acid comes all the time, real. I said, well, okay. So...
But it isn't all the time you introduce a foreign body into your body to make your DNA produce this spike protein.
Yeah.
That doesn't happen all the time.
By the way, this is the RNA process has been going on and been very effective working with cancer patients. I don't know whether you know it, but those patients are using their own RNA to develop antibodies to fight cancer genes. In other words, they will use stem cells from themselves. They go into the spinal cord, get some stem cells. My brother-in-law is doing something similar. They go in, get some stem cells and so forth, and then they use those stem cells to make whatever it is, and then it goes to the, use the ribonucleic acid to carry it to the cells, and then they produce something to fight the cancer cells in their own body. But that's in your own body. It's not outside your body. I want to get, Brandy?
Brandy.
Morning, Brandy.
Good morning.
How are you, Miss Brandy?
I'm good. How are y'all?
I'm doing excellently. What's on your mind?
Well, I was just saying, I was listening to your radio this morning, and me and my sister have gone a year and a half without getting it up until a few weeks ago, and we don't have the vaccine. We love a good conspiracy theory, but we don't think our government's going to waste a bunch of money on chips and all that stuff.
Right.
I just want more.
Can you hang on? Hang on, Brandy. Hang on. I'll come back to you. Okay.
Yeah.
We'll be back.
It's Dollar Down Days at R&R Tire Express. Now's the time to get the tires you need.